Broadway ready for biggest audience of the year after Eve. It is only 10 a.m. but Broadway star Alex Brightman is already sweating. The actor, who plays the delightfully demonic title character in the musical adaptation of The Legite, has joined cast members to rehearse the show's irreverent opening number ahead of Sunday's Tony Awards. Over and over, Brightman and the actors all in street clothes are asked to perform the whole being guessing as cameras track their movement inside the massive Radio City Music Hall. Brightman, who earned a Tony nomination in the role, has two shows the day before and has another later on this night, but his infectious energy and ebullience betray no tiredness. It is his second Tony nod and he earned it from the first to pace himself during what he called a month of craziness, culminating in 3 days of rehearsals. There are endless press and nominee events, and, what he chose, a lot of free souls, chicken. It all comes down to this, he said. Brightman and The Legite will be one of several new shows this season strutting their stuff Sunday, including songs from Into Crowd The Light and Times of the Temptations, The Cher Show, Foyer Boy, Had His Phone, Kiss Me, Tape, Oklahoma. The Prom and Tootsie. Had His Phone singer-songwriter Nate Mitchell's Broadway debut, goes into the publicist with a leading 14 Tony nominations, followed by the 2+ musical Into Crowd built around songs by The Temptations, which received a dozen nominations. The other best musical nominees are the stage adaptations of the hit movies Tootsie and The Legite, and The Biddy, heartwarming The Prom. The best play nominees are the Northern Irish dramas, The Ferryman, from Jeff Butterworth, James Gray and Sink, about Rupert Murdoch, Taylor Mack's Broadway debut, Gary, a sequel to Titus Andronicus, Terrell Albin Benny's Foyer Boy, and Heidi Schreck's What the Constitution Means to Me, a personal tour of the landmark document at the heart of so many American divisions. James Corden, host of The Late Late Show with James Corden and the Tony, winner in his own right, will be the host of the telecast. He previously hosted in 2016, when Hamilton was the juggernaut. This year, he does not see a clear favorite emerging. It's a really eclectic mix this year. I have to say it's a wonderful year because it feels like the field is kind of wide open, he said. It feels like no one is like. That's a lot. Of course, the last time I hosted it, it would have been an outrage if Hamilton hadn't won. Presenters will include Sarah Bareilles, Laura Benanti, Abigail Breslin, Kristen Chenoweth, Helen Frigg, Jesse Tyler Ferguson, Tina Fey, Sutton Foster, Josh Rosen, Danai Gurira, Jake Gyllenhaal, Christopher Jackson, Samuel L. Jackson, Shirley Jones, Regina King, Jane Krakowski, Laura Linney, Lucy Liu, Adit Manji, Audra McDonald, Sienna Miller, Catherine O'Hara, Ben Platt, Billy Porter, Andrew Rannells, Michael Shannon, Brian Stokes Mitchell and Marissa Tomei. Brightman begins his The Legite song in the orchestra seat before joining his fellow actors on stage, amid digital rain, fog, spinning umbrellas and a massive snake or two. The lyrics have been tweaked so he can gently mock some fellow Broadway stars in the hall. It doesn't feel out of the character of our show. No one. Going to take offense because he's just a demon from hell who has boundary issues, says Brightman of his character. Exposure at the Tony Awards last year's telecast was seen by 6.32 million people can provide a key boost to a show's box office receipts. Things like this mean ticket sales. That's lovely. I just want to continue to do the show, says Brightman. In addition to the best play and musical races, there are some intriguing and potentially history-making moments. Will Heidi Schreck, nominated for Best Actress in a Play and with her What the Constitution Means to Me also up for Best Play, be the first to win both awards in a single year? Will Tootsie songwriter David Yost supply the music and lyrics to a second straight Tony Award-winning Best Musical? Last year, Kiss the Band Visit won. Will three-time Emmy winner Laurie Metcalf become the first actress to win an acting Tony back-to-back-to-back? And can Jeremy Pope, in his Broadway debut, win two Tonys for his two roles in the show's Foyer Boy and Into Crowd? Whatever happens Sunday, Broadway is in good shape. The show's this season recorded a record $8 billion in sales, up 7.8% from last season. Attendance was 14.8 million, up 7.1%, and has risen steadily for decades, with the number of theaters in 2018 to 2019 doubled that of 1990 to 1991. Related stories. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.